On 15 January 2023, Nepal Eti airplane with 72 passengers was scheduled to land but crashed minutes before. One of the officials revealed that airport did not have a proper landing guiding system that helps the plane land safely on the runway. Landing guiding system helps pilot to maintain visual contact with obstacles and ground. Pilots in Nepal face in-flight visibility problems as the country is surrounded by mountains. Despite the bad guiding system, weather at the day of the crash was good with low winds and clear skies. It is believed that airplane went into a stall, but it is unclear why. But what is a stall? When plane is speeding up on the runway, the speed of air above the wing is relatively higher than the speed of air beneath the wing. Due to the design of the wing, the shape of the wing allows air to stick to it. If you were to cut out a section of the wing and look at it from the side, it would roughly resemble a teardrop that is cut in half from the tip to tail with curved side pointing up. This is the representation of air streamlines surrounding the wing. Tip of the wing compresses the air more on the top than they do on the bottom. That causes the air on the top of the wing to be denser. Consider an imaginary streamlined tube above the wing. To maintain the same mass flow rate, the speed of air above the tip must be higher than the trailing edge of the wing. Because the area of the tube at the tip is lower than that of a trailing edge. Consider another imaginary stream tube below the wing. Air below the tip is less dense, more spread. So according to mass flow continuity, the speed of air must be slower at the bottom of the wing than that of a trailing edge. The high speed of air above the wing causes the low pressure and the lower speed of air beneath the wing causes high pressure. This pressure difference produces lift and this lift we call Bernoullian lift. But Wright brothers used a nearly flat wing in their plane. The speed of air above and beneath the wing will be almost equal. There will be no lift and it will fall, but Wright brothers' plane flew. The key idea is that air must go down. If you see the air above the wing trailing edge, you can see air is going down. Who makes the air go down? Wing, right? So according to Newton's action reaction law, air pushes the wing in upward direction. Let's look at another example. Why is this sellotape levitating in the air? Air coming from the air gun is making laminar flow surrounding the top portion of the tape. The speed of air above the tape is higher than the speed of air below the tape. According to Bernoulli, air here pushes the tape down with a little pressure than that of air beneath, producing enough lift that balances the tape weight. Here air coming from the air gun after making its contact with the tape is going down. Tape is exerting net downward force on the air, so air exerts force in upward direction that balances the weight of the tape. Bernoulli and Newton explanation gives the same outcomes. It is basically a different way of looking at the same things. When the speed of plane increases, the pressure difference across the wing increases, and when lift becomes equal to weight of the plane, then the plane takes off. During flight, lift balances the weight of the plane and thrust produced by propeller balances the drag produced by air and the plane flies happily. But how to increase the lift during the flight? One way is to change the design of some parts of the wing. Second way is to increase the speed of a plane. Third way is to increase the relative angle of wing with air as it presses more air at the top of the tip. Hence, increasing the speed of air above the wing. In all the methods, we are trying to increase the pressure difference across the wing. Stalls in airplane are commonly but incorrectly associated with stalling a car. When car stalls, engine shuts off. When plane stalls, the wings are not producing as much lift as required for a controlled flight. During a stall, air unsticks from the wing. Speed of air above the wing becomes slow and disrupted, and that causes lift to decrease drastically. But why does this all happen? To understand why, we need to know angle of attack. It is the angle between relative wind and chord line. As the angle of attack increases, if everything else stays the same, lift increases and amount of drag increases too. Once the angle of attack increases beyond a certain point, the air no longer flows smoothly around the wing. It starts to separate from the wing and become turbulent. This is known as stalling. When wing stalls, lift decreases rapidly and at the same time, drag increases. Nepal airplane was pointed upward, nosed up before crash. Let's understand what might have happened at the time. When the plane goes into a steep climb, nosed up, the propeller cannot keep it at enough speed. The pilot increases angle of attack to increase the lift. But if angle of attack becomes too high, air starts separating from the wing and becomes turbulent. That causes the lift force to decrease drastically and it leads to stall. Stalls are very dangerous because when they happen, the aircraft effectively suddenly becomes a deadweight and it will do what deadweight does, fall. Propellers and steering to a large degree also rely on a certain amount of airflow to operate. This means that if you stall, you need to be in position where you are able to orient the plane so that you can then get sufficient sticky air flow around the wing to get the engines going and the plane flying. If you are able to get the nose straight, either down or somewhat forward, you can get out of it. But that might not have happened, and the ill-fated Nitti airplane crashed down. Thanks for watching.